When we come to I, instead of innovation, I want to share with you, I wish I had thought of that. This, to me, is actually something really cool. And this is a piece of work that's been led by Ken Burnett, and this is a piece of work which is about Sophie. And we're not promoting this for any other reason other than this is a charity, and it's actually the Online Museum of Fundraising. This is rich in content. This is your heritage, not just from the UK, all over the world. Many, many Canadian contributors. This is amazing. So I've chosen three examples to actually say, I wish I'd thought of that, and these are my favorites. It's hard to say this is a favorite because it's one of the most shocking packs I've ever seen. This is what they call the Amnesty Pen Pack. And this is well documented on Sophie. And this, to me, works at every single level. It shocks, it's relevant, and it's the only pack I've ever seen where I actually believe a pen should be in it, because it actually talks about that pen being an instrument of torture. It brings it to life. It was one of the most phenomenal groundbreaking packs. To please embrace our heritage, ladies and gentlemen, it's not just about the new stuff, it's about the old stuff too.
What I want to talk to you about is joy. I want to talk to you about what's inside of us. And not only what's inside of us, but what we create in our donors. Most of us have had an extraordinary person who has influenced our life, perhaps shaped our career. It certainly happened to me. And this was the gentleman, this very mild-mannered gentleman. His name was Hank Rosso, and he founded something called the Fundraising School. When people said to you, what do you do? He said, I teach the joy of giving. And he believed that fundraising was the gentle art of teaching the joy of giving. People give to us because they are grateful for what we do. They're grateful for what life has given them that allows them to invest in us. What good is the money if I am not investing it in the world that I deeply care about? Joy can be wild, it can be enthusiastic, it can be quiet, it can be simple. Be sure that you are bringing joy to your donors by the way you thank them.
Whoa!
Learn something every single day. You all should stand up or just give yourselves a hand for doing all that good work, folks.
What is love? Compassion, affection, caring, consideration. There are different kinds of love. Sexual love, romantic love, the love of family and friends. Religion talks a lot about love. Islam describes love as universal brotherhood. Confucianism describes love as duty and action. We fundraisers talk a lot about love. It's called philanthropy, the love of humankind, according to the Greeks. Voluntary action for the common good. That moment when it goes beyond self-interest and family love and extends out into the wider community. Love for our communities. The love that translates into activism and social movements like ending apartheid, like women's rights, like fighting for peace. Wouldn't it be curious maybe if they took the Nobel Peace Prize and started to call it the Love Prize? Individuals taking action, those acts of love. We call them philanthropists, don't we? And we all know famous philanthropists. We can name them. Stephen Lewis, Margot Franson here in Canada. But what about the not famous ones? The ones you and I are working with every single day back home. How about the philanthropist next to you, behind you? Somebody, give me a name of one of your philanthropists right now, or I'll point at you. Give me a name of one of your philanthropists back home.
Sam Switzer.
Sam, give me another one.
Deborah O'Malley.
Wonderful. Somebody else? Cool. All of these philanthropists united in these acts of love.
All you need is love. too often I think that money becomes the object of our work. You know, and money is not the object of work, and we all know that. It's about mission. It's about message. It's about mission and message. It's about doing those things that are really important to us. M is for mission and message. And if we get that right, we'll never have to worry about the money. The money will follow.
Each procedure I get a bead.
Why don't you tell them what some of the beads are for?
These are finger pokes, chemo, spinal tap, cord access.
She's the one who actually gets us through it. She just takes everything as it comes. She deals with it. And then she just waits for the time when she can be happy. Like this.
Don't, you silly girl.
She's more than inspirational.
So, you know, we've been in the neighborhood speaking with people just like you, asking them to join the Every Member campaign by making a manageable monthly contribution. You know, they all agree the need for excellence in philanthropy is greater than ever before, and the response has really been great, so I'm sure we can count on your support as well, too, right?
No.
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 Yeah, guys. Well, you're all probably wondering what I'm doing here, right? A question I get asked a lot every day is, you know, how do you get up every day, go to work with a smile on your face, knowing that you're gonna hear the word no, no, no? How do you stay positive? Even when a donor says no, I've still created awareness. And I think we can all agree that this is a positive thing. What really helps me is that I know that no matter what, the more no's that I get, the more I'm helping the charity reach their cause, and the more I'm helping the charity to change the world. So when you're on the streets and if you face a tough situation, think about it that way. Think about that every no that you get is helping to move the charity closer to their goal, and you as a fundraiser are helping to change the world. So I'm pretty sure we can count on all of your support today, right? Thank you.
Passion and philanthropy belong together in one phrase.
Philanthropy?
That's a hard word.
I don't know what it is, but I bet it's good.
Philanthropy.
A desire to help mankind,
especially as shown by gifts to charitable or humanitarian institutions.
And we do it for love. What a calling. What a privilege. What a joy. How lucky are we? How lucky are we? Woo!
So now we come to Q. And you know, at this point in the show, we thought, well, why don't we make you do some work? Why don't we actually get you to answer Q? Because every fundraiser in this room knows that questioning is critical. Our job is to question everything. Do not accept anything. You need to question the cause, the donor, everything. So earlier this week, we came amongst you and we actually asked you, what are the key questions we need to consider?
Wow, that's an interesting question. Okay, let's see.
Let me think about that.
Guys, I need to phone a friend.
A question.
I can't answer that question.
I don't know.
You're not filming this right now, are you?
You in the audience? Yes, we were. Now, now the big thing is actually that I could now go into a very, very long discussion about questioning. And I can give you lots of theory, but let's just tell you it's very, very simple. There's only one question you ever have to take with you as a fundraiser in life. Why? That's it. Simple as that, really.
Well, I have a why question for you.
why would they bring the single girl out to speak about relationships? Relationships are at the very heart of our existence and our being, and they are most definitely at the heart of good fundraising. And earlier this August, I was happy enough to meet up with the guru himself, the man who literally wrote the book on relationship fundraising, Mr. Ken Burnett. And he had some interesting things to tell me. You're not agreeing?
No. You see, the thing is, Ken, good friend of mine, been at this Congress many times, and he is fabulous.
He is.
But it's a book, 272 pages on relationships. Does it have to be that hard?
Well, I don't know, I'm single.
Well, you see, the thing for me is let me just make it very basic. Let me prepare you as you go forth in your journey to maybe not be single.
Okay.
So you see, the big thing for me is that human relationships start with willingness, respect, and trust. In fact, I'll tell you what, think about when we met at that bar in Holland. Oh, remember it well. Our eyes met across the bar. Mm-hmm. It was quite special.
Great conversation.
It's lived with me for a long time.
Yes.
And you see, we got that respect for each other, and we said, let's work together. And we're here now, aren't we? Mm-hmm. Which is fabulous. And then, of course, we started to build a friendship. We do all these modern things you do, like Twitter and Google Documents, which I still don't understand. But it works for me, because we're building a relationship, which is kind of cool.
We are.
And you know, I know this is probably not the time, but you get to a stage where you have to take the relationship up another level.
Good luck.
You get to a stage when you want to get intimate. Aww. And I've decided we should get intimate. I've decided that I think I've fallen in love. I think you're the girl for me. And I think we need to take our relationship up another level. So B, will you be my girl?
I love you, Tony, I do, but you're a bit high maintenance for me.